How to slice and dice a dataset. Most of the time, the data you work with won't be perfectly prepared for training models. In this video, we'll explore various features that the datasets library provides to clean up your data. The datasets library provides several built-in methods that allow you to wrangle your data in various ways. In this video, we'll see how you can shuffle and split your data, select the rows you're interested in, tweak the columns, and apply processing functions with the map method. Let's start with shuffling. It is generally a good idea to apply shuffling to your training set so that your model doesn't learn any artificial ordering in the data. If you want to shuffle the whole data set, you can apply the appropriately named shuffle method. You can see an example of this method in action here, where we've downloaded the training split of the squad data set and shuffled all the rows randomly. Another way to shuffle the data is to create random train and test splits. This can be useful if you have to create your own test splits from raw data. To do this, you just apply the train test split method and specify how large the test split should be. In this example, we specify that the test set should be 10% of the total dataset size. You can see that the output of the train test split method is a dataset dict object whose keys correspond to the new splits. Now that we know how to shuffle the dataset, let's take a look at returning the rows we're interested in. The most common way to do this is with the select method. This method expects a list or a generator of the dataset's indices and will then return a new dataset object containing just those rows. If you want to create a random sample of rows, you can do this by chaining the shuffle and select methods together. In this example, we've created a sample of 5 elements from the squad dataset. The last way to pick out specific rows in a dataset is by applying the filter method. This method checks whether each row fulfills some condition or not. For example, here we've created a small lambda function that checks whether the title starts with the letter L. Once we apply this function with the filter method, we get a subset of the data just containing these rows. So far, we've been talking about the rows of a dataset, but what about the columns? The datasets library has 2 main methods for transforming columns: a rename column method to change the name of the column, and a remove columns method to delete them. You can see examples of both these methods here. Some datasets have nested columns, and you can expand these by applying the flatten method. For example, in the squad dataset, the answers column contains a text and answer start field. If we want to promote them to their own separate columns, we can apply flatten as shown here. Now, of course, no discussion of the datasets library would be complete without mentioning the famous map method. This method applies a custom processing function to each row in the dataset. For example, here, we first define a lowercase title function that simply lowercases the text in the title column. And then we feed that function to the map method, and voila, we now have lowercase titles. The map method can also be used to feed batches of rows to the processing function. This is especially useful for tokenization, where the tokenizers are backed by the tokenizers library, and they can use fast multi-threading to process batches in parallel.